On the president's request for lawmakers not to pursue impeachment raps against the vice president. Joining us now is political analyst Edmund Dayao of the Institute of Policy and Governance. Professor, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Casey. Good afternoon. I'm with Pierce, Political Economic Elemental Research.
Correct. Sorry about that. Okay, going back to the issue at hand, the president there admitting sending that text message to lawmakers to sort of discourage them from filing an impeachment complaint against the vice president. Is this sort of an attempt to put the toothpaste back in the tube? And is it going to work, Professor?
Casey, if you remember, a number of times we've talked about possible impeachment, possible moves on the part of the president or Malacanang for that matter. And I've always said that, or even including that of the House of Representatives, if they will be pushing for impeachment. And I've always said if they really wanted to do impeachment from the very start, they would have done it already, you know, because there were enough reasons for them to pursue it in the first place. First of all, when we say impeachment, it's not even a criminal, outright criminal proceeding. It follows procedures out of a criminal proceeding. But, the provisions in the Constitution that are used to start or pursue impeachment rather is open to interpretation. And so they could have pursued that earlier on. What I know and from the discussions that I happen to have known and heard is that even the members of Congress have always thought that what the more important thing is really bring out the truth in the public, at the very least determine really how best to provide the budget to particular agencies. Mm-hmm. It will take time for us to really discuss how agencies do this and do that. But with respect to Ayuda, for example, it's not like it's done by particular elected officials. It's always done through the DSWD. And so that's what the House of Representatives have been pursuing all this time. No, but the problem is the group of or the side of the vice president has not been really bending any or considering any compromise for that matter. And last but not the least, I can't avoid but say that it seems they're really actually taunting the administration. They're taunting the House of Representatives. They're taunting the president to actually pursue impeachment and even with this file a case against them, put them behind bars and so on and so forth, because that will make a martyr out of them. Mm-hmm. From day one, I think the game plan really is get the people back to EDSA and call for a change of administration. In other words, the game plan from the very start is use extra constitutional means to get back to power. So some would disagree with me, but all you have to do is really put the two and two things together, what the former president has been doing and saying and what the vice president has been doing and saying, and more importantly, how the supporters have been acting and organizing in support of all this pronouncement.
Okay, here's the thing, though. With that, with the president admitting to sending that text message discouraging lawmakers to file impeachment raps against the vice president, two things there. Number one, can the president actually do that? I mean, it's supposed to be an independent body, right? Of course, it's just an appeal, but it's making his sentiments known to the lawmakers. And it's sort of already influencing their actions. And presumably, these are supposed to be independent representatives representing the people. The president can appeal, right, can urge, but ultimately, if there is evidence, enough evidence to file impeachment raps against the vice president, wouldn't it be tantamount to the betrayal of their mandate to the people whom they represent if they choose not to file impeachment, an impeachment case against the vice president, Professor?
You know, Casey, just to be clear, no, the impeachment as an option, not only in the Constitution, but even in the origin of which is the United States of America, it is defined really as a political option or the political mechanism. Again, that's why I distinguish it from at the outset that it may follow a criminal procedure or a criminal steps, but at the end of the day, it's a political measure, no? Which means that as a political measure, whether we like it or not, whether the president or not, and so on and so forth, it's not one, it's open to interpretation because, again, the rules or the provisions are requiring not only of evidence but also of interpretation of the provisions. Second, because it's political, you have to weigh not only the quote-unquote the legal implications, but also the overall political implications, even social implications. That's why precisely I've been trying to explain that what they're trying to do is to taunt the House of Representatives, taunt the president to act so that will make a martyr out of them. No, ultimately also no, precisely because of reasons one and two. That means that the president, just like any political leader, can make an appeal. Mm-hmm. So it's not like the president is the one making the decision for the House of Representatives. It's trying to at least remind them that this is not really paramount an issue, no, as far or paramount a function as far as the government or the House of Representatives is concerned, but prioritize governance, prioritize a passing of laws, mm-hmm. Instead of continuing with all this political bickering.
As you correct.
Tatagalugin ko para sa mga nakikinig.
Sige po.
Kung tatanungin ninyo, in summary, no? Sa totoo lang, ito ay puro ingay. Pag pinatulan, lalaki. So, mas magandang hindi na patulan. Kasi pagka pinatulan mo, you will be playing into their trap, and ultimately the losers are not only the Marcoses or the administration. The losers ultimately is the all of the Filipinos, the whole of the country. We've seen how extra constitutional moves have impacted on our economy, mm-hmm. on our people, and so you don't want to go through that again.
Mm-hmm.
No? So that's why I'm quite disappointed why this is even being pursued by the followers of the vice president and the former president.
All right, Professor. Basically, as you pointed out, it's both a legal and political process, right? When you talk about the impeachment,
it's a legal process because it provides steps.
Correct.
But ultimately, it's a political tool.
Correct. So it may make sense legally. But politically, at this point in our history, it won't make any sense for the
yes.
Filipino people in general. Take away the president,
That's
take
right.
away the vice president.
That's right. That's
All right.
right. Ultimately, at the end of the day, everyone will be a loser here.
Okay. And then, of course, when you talk about the timing, right? The elections is just around the corner. Is it even possible for them to go ahead with the impeachment process knowing that the May elections is just around the corner, Professor?
Well, the fact that this is happening, it means that any of the interests involved somehow is looking, no, at the midterm election as something that may be set aside, no, and instead proceed with the change of leadership. So yun nga yung nakaka-disappoint dito, eh, no? So it could be taken to mean that it just so happened that this is happening now, just a few months before the midterm election. It could also be interpreted as a time precisely before the midterm election. Take note that when the former president, Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, took over, it was towards the end of the first half of of the presidency of former President Herb Estrada. Mm. Now, if you look at the Constitution, no, if the vice president took over, no, before that three-year period, she could have just served as president during the unexpired term of the president, and will no longer be allowed to run again, precisely because there's only one term that is allowed by the Constitution. Mm. But if a president has already almost, no, that means more than 2 years, no, a sitting president has already served his time in office, you can't proceed with any extra constitutional means, or it is not advisable to take over as president, because you can no longer run for election. No, kaya pasensya na kung medyo malisyoso yung tingin ko, no, pero kung timing ang pag-uusapan, this is the time. If you intend you know, a vice president to take over as president and to run again for president and therefore serve as chief executive for more than 6 years, no, so I'm not saying that is the intent, but it could have been a consideration.
All right. Going back to the hearings that we've been seeing at the House of Representatives, also at the Senate, the QuadCom, the Committee on Good Government, and all that, where is this all headed? Because I think a lot of people won't be able to accept that this is just all noise. For this to be not just all noise, for this to be not just, you know, a product of motivations coming from, you know, vested interests, what must these committees present and do? And what must the people expect from these lawmakers so that it will not go the way of the other hearings that we've seen in the past administrations, wherein it created a lot of drama, it created a lot of noise, but at the end of the day, it was all just that. Professor.
I will have to disagree with that, Casey. No, you know, first of all, when we say that it's all drama and that there's nothing that is accomplished, actually, there's already something that is accomplished here. First of all, there's a reason why people seem to be divided, because there are those who have been keeping tab of, you know, the proceedings that have been happening, meaning they are able to distinguish the substance from the, you know, all this politicking, and therefore have already drawn, you know, more objective conclusions to that effect. Just to give you an idea. Mm-hmm. If, again, if I may repeat, and I'm sure you've heard me say this, no, as far as the vice president is concerned, if really the questions that are being asked or accusations that are being thrown at her are not true, bakit hindi mo sagutin? Mas magandang sagutin mo yan, do away with it, set it aside, so that it would be best, so that it would be more effective when it's your time to make the accusation. Ang problema, hindi nga sinasagot eh. Iniiba yung usapan. Mm-hmm. So, ano pang iisipin mo dito? Eh, you're diverting the attention. So, that alone, to my mind, is already an accomplishment. Second, when you say politics, whether you like it or not, Carmina, and I'm sure you will agree, hindi mo naman maiiwasan dito yung mga ulterior motives, yung mga interest. Lahat yan may interest. Kahit tayo may interest. So, pag politika po ang pinag-usapan, whether we like it or not, eh talaga pong may interest, hindi mo maiiwasan yan. Pangatlo, huling-huli, yung pong resulta na sinasabi natin, hindi naman yan ibig sabihin may makukulong, may makakasuhan. Ang importante, again, because this is more politics, no? I don't want to think it's pure politics, but it's more politics, whether we like it or not, no? What your ultimate objective is to get to that general perception that your side is the right side and the other side is not. And so it's not just having to put someone in jail or having to you know, throw all the legal gobbledygook against the person, no? Because baka iba pa yung maging epekto kung ganun na gawin mo, kasi nga magiging martir itong mga ito eh.
No? Kaya nga po, so I guess the final question here is, Professor, sa lahat ng mga itong nakikita natin, paano tayo makakasiguro na at the end of the day, right? At the end, how can we be sure that at the end of the day, The Filipino people will emerge as the winner outside of the politicking that we're seeing, outside the vested interests that we're seeing. Ano ba ang dapat nating asahan? Should it go by way of, you know, laws really that will be filed to streamline processes here, outside of the personalities involved? Go ahead, Professor.
You know, I'm sorry to say I can't think of any with this definitive or sabihin na natin siguradong path so that we will win, na? And we will emerge victorious, no? And we will actually gain something positive in this regard.
Mm-hmm.
But on the other hand, if we go back in time, no, at ang kung gusto ng ibang grupo o yung ibang tao na ang akala nila yung nakikita nila at yung ingay na nadidinig nila, yun ang katotohanan, balikan po natin ang ating kasaysayan. Pagkatapos po ng 1986 at 2001, nagkaroon po ng, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, tatlo pang attempt na magkaroon ng extra-constitutional means of unseating a sitting president. Lahat yon nag-fizzle out. And precisely, this is the reason why we have a president who will go down in history, who served, no, as practically the most unpopular president. That was the only time that surveys have been showing that the former president Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, no, siya lang yung dumating doon sa punto na negative pa nga, mm-hmm, yung trust rating na lumalabas.
Mm-hmm.
Pero hindi natuloy yung EDSA. And to be fair with former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, hindi ko sasabihin na nagtagal siya doon na hindi siya popular, pero maraming na-accomplish, maraming mga gandang batas. Isa po doon yung disaster risk reduction ng 2010, no? Napakahabang proseso. So, sa madalit sabi, no, ang hirap mong sabihin na yung political, hindi mo pwedeng i-mix sa performance ng gobyerno. Kasi minsan, yung perception natin, popular, akala natin magaling, pero hindi naman.
Mm-hmm.
Minsan, hindi naman popular, pero kahit papano, merong nade-deliver.
Mm-hmm.
So, kung ako ang tatanungin, kung lalalim, kung nakikita natin na walang pupuntahan itong sarsuela na ito, baka sakali ultimately, Casey, no, I'm not just injecting it, but I've written a number of commentaries and analysis in your website, ABS-CBN,
mm-hmm,
and I've always been suggesting that ultimately, hopefully, this will further educate the people and convince them that the way forward is to change the system. Kasi sabi mo nga, and at the end of the day, puro personalities. Yun kasi yung setup natin ngayon, Casey.
Mm-hmm.
Hanggat hindi natin binabago, hanggat hindi tayo naglalagay ng tamang political party, ng tamang electoral system, ganito po tayo, personalan at appeal to emotion palagi.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Professor Edmund Tayo there, who is the president and CEO of the group PEERS, which stands for Political Economic Elemental Researchers and Strategists. As always, thank you, Professor, for joining us today.
Salamat, salamat.
Ingat po.